that I no longer wish to give a sacrifice of praise.
Thank you, Jesus.
The definition of sacrifice is the surrender or destruction of something prized or desirable for the sake of something considered as having a higher or more pressing claim. I don't want to sacrifice to the Lord. I'm giving my praise freely. I'm giving my praise because I want to. It's not hard. It's not grievous. It's not something that I want to keep to myself. I want to give it to the Lord and want him to know that I'm praising him, that I'm exalting him, that I'm magnifying his name, that I love him, that I want to be near him. I want to draw near him. I want to know more about him. I want to thank and praise him because my praise is willing. My praise is loving.
Jesus.
My praise is desire to give. Not something I want to keep for myself because I'm not worthy. He's worthy of all the praise, honor, and glory. And I give him my praise freely.
Amen. Can we say amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord, Sister Black.
Jesus is the sweetest name I know.
All the testimonies and just for being in the house of the Lord one more time. Amen. Can we say amen?
Amen.
Let us all stand as we receive our suffering and bishop. I mean, I keep making myself not say this.
It's all right.
Our suffering and bishop have a good day hope. Say amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everyone.
Amen.
Give me some more volume on this. It's our pastor.
Our pastor.
Now, if you want to add the title, that's fine.
Okay.
but our pastor.
Amen.
That's the way it's supposed to be.
Oh, okay.
I'm your pastor long before I become suffering bishop.
Amen.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
We're going to, we thank God to see everyone in the house of the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
And for his kindness to us. Yeah. We're going to Hosea.
Thank you, Jesus.
In our scripture reading. I seem to be impressed to read the second chapter again.
All right.
Excuse me. The chapter in which I read, it means so much if you understand it, if you permit God to open your understanding. But if you're only here to read scripture, you will read scripture and lose out on what the chapter is all about. But God is angry at his people in that time. And as he is angry today with his people, because they are not concerned with what he wants, they're more concerned about what we want. And when you say you don't want to be a sacrifice, I want you to understand, you have to sacrifice you. Because what you want to do is what this world has got. You may get to the place you serve God because you want to. But you got to give up the desires of this world, and it ain't easy. Because they keep knocking on your door. It keeps coming back. And in order to stay, and you got to sacrifice family, friends, husbands, wives, desires that in the world, you got to sacrifice those because they're knocking at your door. And that's what Satan presents. You may be able to fight the sacrifice a little harder and have something to help you, but you got to sacrifice. Come on. It takes a sacrifice to give your time to the Lord. Because the time you ought to be reading, you're not. The time you ought to be studying, you're not. You're doing something else. You have to shut down and open up to Jesus in order to get it done. Hosea. Excuse me while I change glasses. I don't want to look through those slits. Say ye unto your brethren, Ami, and to your sister, Ruhuma.
Neither am I her husband. Let her therefore put away her whoredoms out of her sight, and her adulteries from between her breasts.
Lest I strip her naked, and set her as in the day that she was born, and make her as a wilderness, and set her like a dry land, and slay her with thirst.
I will not have mercy upon her children, for they be children of whoredoms.
For their mother hath played the harlot. She that conceived them hath done shamefully. For she said, I will go after my lovers. They give me my bread and my water, my wool. Excuse me. I will go after my lovers. They give me my bread and my water and my wool and my flax and mine oil and my drink. Now I want to explain something. In case you don't see, well, that's relative today. to go to my job because I got to take care of me. I got to make my living. One of the great things that people use, I got to go to work. I got to get up and go to work. Where in time past, they was in church from 1 or 2 o'clock and had to be off to work at 4 o'clock. And they did it. Talking about sacrifice. When you get to talking, this is what it's all about. See, you thinking of a sugar daddy giving you what you want. But listen to what it says. Read.
Therefore, behold, I will hedge up thy way with thorns and make a wall that she shall not find her path.
God can cut you off from work. God can cut you off. When you think that your work is more important than that of God, of serving God. And there's so many things that we allow to block our way. And don't think God don't know that you're happy doing what you're doing so you don't have to come to church. You have a good excuse not to come. See, what you're hiding is your excuse from me. You're hiding your excuse from me. But you don't know that God knows your excuse. And you have to get over hiding it from the pastor. And when you can get past hiding it from the pastor, then you can serve God like you ought to serve him. And she shall follow after her lovers, but she shall not overtake them. And she shall seek them, but shall not find them. Then shall she say, I will go and return to my first husband, for then was it better with me than now.
For she did not know that I gave her corn and wine and oil, multiplied her silver and gold, which they prepared for Baal.
You didn't know that God gave it to you. They thought at that time, as Hosea was writing, that they got it because of what they did. They have what they have because of their ingenuity. They thought they got what they have. See, Israel right now, when God took them out of the land went to where it was a desert. They've come back to the land. God has caused that land to bloom and to sprout and to flourish. Guess who you think they think done it? But if you read God's word, while they were gone, he said, when you get back, I'll do this. See, we got to quit thinking about what we're doing. God needs that. Therefore, will I return and take away my corn in the time thereof, and my wine in the season thereof, and will recover my wool and my flax, given to cover her nakedness.
And now will I discover her lewdness in the sight of her lovers, and none shall deliver her out of my hand.
I will also cause all her mirth to cease, her feast days, her new moons, and her Sabbaths, and all her solemn feasts. You have to understand this scripture. Don't think you have, and you can do what you want to do, because it's you and your ingenuity. God did it. When you feel that you've done this and you've done it on your own, that's when you'll lose out. That's what Satan wants you to do. And then he can begin to lead you when he can get you to thinking in those terms. And I will destroy her vines. Excuse me, you read that, didn't you? It's the 11th verse?
Yes.
Read, it's your turn then.
And I will destroy her vines
and her fig trees, whereof she hath said, these are my rewards that my lovers have given me, and I will make them a forest, and the beasts of the field shall eat them.
And I will visit upon her the days of Baal, wherein she burned incense to them, and she decked herself with her earrings and her jewels, and she went after her lovers, and forget me, saith the Lord.
Therefore, behold, I will allure her, and bring her into the wilderness, and to be comfortable with her.
And I will give her vineyards, and I will give her her vineyards from thence, and the valley of Achor for a door of hope. And she shall sing there, as in the days of her youth, and as in the day when she came up out of the land of Egypt.
And she shall hear thee at that day, saith the Lord, that thou shalt call me Ishah, and shalt call me no more Baali.
And I will take away the names of Baalim out of her mouth, and they shall no more be remembered by their name.
And in that day will I make a covenant with them, with the beasts of the field, and with the fowls of heaven, and with the creeping things of the ground. And I will break the bow and the sword and the battle out of the earth, and will make them to lie down safely.
And I will betroth thee unto me forever. Yea, I will betroth thee unto me in righteousness, and in judgment, and in loving kindness, and in mercies.
I will even betroth thee unto me in faithfulness, and thou shalt know the Lord.
And it shall come to pass in that day, I will hear, saith the Lord, I will hear the heavens, and they shall hear the earth.
And the earth shall hear the corn, and the wine, and the oil, and they shall hear Jezreel.
Altogether. And I will sow her unto me in the earth, and I will have mercy upon her that had not obtained mercy. And I will say unto them which are not my people, thou art my people, and they shall say, thou art my God. Heavenly Father, we thank you, and we praise you, and we give thy name glory. Thou alone art God, and there is none else. All power in heaven and earth is in thine hand. It is you that has delivered us from darkness and into the marvelous light. Bless those that have come in. Give them strength. Give them understanding. Bless those that are absent for the different reasons that they're absent. And Lord, you understand their reasoning for not being here. But let your spirit abide. Those that desire to be here but could not, reach out to them and bless them and encourage. Those that are traveling, travel with them. Guide them and keep them, we pray. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.